Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace Aleya. First of all, I want to give you my best wishes for 2019. 2018 was a great year. I know for a fact that 2019 is going to be way better. As long as we're together, there's nothing that can stop us, so I hope that you guys are ready for it. In today's video, I will be showing you how to fake Northern Light in Adobe After Effects just like this. Alright, I hope you enjoyed that little preview. This is what we are going to be creating today in Adobe After Effects. If you want the same footage like I was using, you can download that with the link in the description below. And if you enjoy watching my videos, definitely hit subscribe and hit the notification bell so you stay notified when I upload new videos. And without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects. This is the footage that I will be using in order to create the effect. If you want to use the same footage as me, I will put a link in the description below so you can go ahead and download that, follow along with this tutorial. It has a little bit of movement, which we will be tracking down as well. And in the preview, you will hear... And as you heard in the preview, the nice background atmospheric sound and the sound effects used in this preview are from epidemicsound.com. They provide royalty-free music which you can use commercially or in your YouTube videos. They have a sound effects library and music library which is growing every single day. It's an amazing service. I do have a link in the description below, and if you click on my link, you get 30 days for free, so definitely go and check out our website. So what I will do is drag my footage into a new composition like this. Now we have this in our new composition. What we'll do is create another composition by going over here and create a new composition. Make sure it's a full HD resolution, and we're going to rename this Fractal Noise. In this composition, I'm going to right click and create a new solid layer. And this is going to be our fractal fur one. And give it some kind of color. It doesn't really matter, and click OK. Now I'm going to effect noise and grain and apply a fractal noise effect to this layer. The first thing that I want to do is go into the complexity and change this to 1. Then go into the fractal type, change this to max, and go to the noise type and change this to a spline. Now we have something like this, which looks great. We can just click the invert button right here, and that's going to create something like this. Then we can increase the contrast to really isolate these kind of ripples or these kind of lines. We can also play with the brightness to really narrow it down. Just make sure that the brightest part is actually white and not kind of grayish like here. So make sure that we do have real white, and then you can increase the contrast a little bit more if you want to. Then you can open up the transform setting and play with the uniform scaling. So make sure that the scale width and height are separate, and then you can play around like this and just play around with it. Add a little bit more contrast, and something like this should work fine. And we can open up the evolution options and also play with the random seeds. So we can click on this and just with the arrow up until you find something that you like. So it's completely up to you. Of course, you can bring down the height even more to get something like this. And then we can create a new solid layer, and this is going to be Fractal 02. And then here we apply the same effect, effects, noise and grain, and apply a fractal noise. This noise is going to be on top of our other fractal, so we're going to change this to some kind of multiply effect, and that way you get some kind of noise types in your fractal. We can also open the transform and increase the scale, and this is just going to give some kind of imperfections in your lines, something like this. Once you've done that, we can click on our first fractal and give it some kind of animation. To do this, we're going to hold Alt on the keyboard and click on the stopwatch for the evolution, right, time times 5. So this is going to give a very slow animation to our fractal, something like this. We can do the same for the other fractal, but in here we can maybe increase it a little bit more. So I'll click on the stopwatch for the evolution and write time times 15. Click OK. So now we have something that looks like this, a very subtle animation. Now we want to pre-compose these two layers together, so we're going to click on both of these, holding the Control button on your keyboard, and going to Layer, pre-compose this, and rename this to Fractal Noise Type. Once you've done that, we can toggle the switches until you see this option to create a 3D layer out of it. Then we can press the W key on our keyboard, that enables the rotation tool, and then we can rotate it to look somewhat kind of like this, because this is going to be in the sky, so that's what we're actually looking for. Increase the scale just like you want it to. And there we have it. Next, we want to click here, go to Layer, and pre-compose it once again, and move all the attributes into the new composition. This is going to be our Fractal 3D. Click OK. Now if you go back to your original composition and you import the fractal noise effect, you'll see that you don't have a black background entirely. So what you want to do is go back to the fractal noise and go new and create a new solid layer. Make sure it's black and rename it BG for background. Put it on the bottom and check it again. Now it should work fine. So next what you want to do is click on the fractal 3D and go with your pen tool around the areas that you don't want to see. So something like this, kind of key out the part that you want to see here. We're going to key out that part and just do whatever you think looks good. Play around with it also. Play around with the settings in the fractal noise as well. So every kind of, everyone that is following this tutorial is definitely going to get different results. So just playing around is the best option that you have. So if you go back here, this is what we see. So in the fractal noise layer, we want to click on the fractal 3D. And now we're going for effect generate. And we're going to apply the four color gradient. And if we bring in these dots here, so if you click on it, you will see these dots all over your screen. We want to kind of drag these in to really enhance those colors. And then we want to change those colors to something more realistic. So right here, if we're going to change the blending mode to color, you will see that it now takes the color right here. You can also play around with multiply or different kind of blending modes. And of course, I don't know how Northern Light actually looks like in real life. I'm only having the reference of photography and videos, and it's still on my bucket list actually to see Northern Light. It seems really amazing, but I haven't had the chance to see it myself. So I think you have to go more into the green and cyan colors, something like this, and then play around with these colors until you're satisfied. Of course, you can play around with your own creativity and really kind of change the colors. I've also seen people pulling off like red kind of purplish colors, which is also pretty cool. So really play around with this until you have something like that. And actually right now you do see some kind of errors because we are using our mask, and that's actually because we have to pre-compose this. So what I'll do is click on my effect, go to edit and cut this effect away, select my background layer, my fractal 3D, and go for layer, pre-compose, and then there we go, paste your effect here again, and now you won't have that problem. So now what rests us to do is really get that effect going. So what I'll do is click on my layer right here and go for edit, duplicate, and then we wanna go for effect, blur and sharpen, and apply a CC fast blur, which is, well, radial blur, sorry. CC radial blur, there we go. And now we're gonna change this to a fading zoom and increase the amount like this. And now we wanna bring down the center here, and we wanna bring it down on Y until we actually see it completely straight up. So there we go, something like this should work fine. And actually you can play around, you can make it less intense, really play around with all these settings. And then of course, the amount is like 25. There we go. This is something that we want. So something like an amount of 1. And then we want to duplicate it once more. Click on layer, duplicate it. Now change it to like 2. Duplicate it. Change it to like 3. Duplicate it, and 4. And now of course toggle the switches and play with the blending mode. Change it to a screen for all of them. And now we're getting something. Of course you can duplicate it once more and maybe increase it even more. Something like that looks really, really cool. I'm also going to change my resolution to full here because we do see some kind of artifacts. And now for the last layer, so our first layer where we didn't apply any kind of effect, we want to go for effect, blur and sharpen, and use a directional blur in this case, and just increase the length to kind of blur it out a little bit. We can also duplicate this one even and maybe increase it even more. Really play around with everything. We can see this kind of sharp edge, which we don't like. So to kind of solve that, we can click on our original layer. And I think the problem lies in the radial blurs. So what you can do is also apply a simple blur and directional blur on these, just very slightly, something like maybe a 10 or a 5. And copy this and apply it to all of the others. And now it's gonna soften this out right here. So that's really what we're looking into. And also change this to a screen. There we go. And also you can select all of these and just change the blending mode like this to see different options. And add is also pretty cool. Classic color dodge is not doing anything. Okay, so screen it is. I'm going back to my original footage and now change this blending mode also to a screen or add. And now you're gonna see your Northern Light right here. Of course, my scene looks a little bit too clear. What you can do if you really wanna dive into this is check out my other video on how to change a day to a night scene. So a lot of techniques that will be covered in there. I'll try to also put that video in the link in the description below. So we click on our video and I'm just gonna quickly head over to curves and just darken it like this. Kind of introduce some blue. I'm just gonna do it very roughly. In the other video you will see a lot more fun things covered. And also increase some contrast. And then go for color correction tint to kind of desaturate it a little bit because the night is kind of desaturated. Now we have something like this. What I'll do is right click, transform and flip horizontal so we don't have the tree covered. Of course you can go ahead and key out the tree and then you'll have to check out my keying tutorial on how to do sky replacement. That's gonna help you a ton, but this looks good. So now we just need to do the animation. So of course we see the camera moving and the sky isn't moving with it. So what we'll do is click on our original footage and go for track motion, or actually what am I? And go for the tracker. So if you don't see that, go to window and enable the tracker right here and click on track camera for your original footage. So once that's doing its thing, just leave it analyzing in the background. We're gonna click on our fractal noise and we're gonna apply our perfect glow preset, which is a free preset that you can get on our website. So perfect glow. And if we apply that, we can see that's doing a magical thing. So it looks really, really cool. We can actually just not show it, and you can see that the glow really does a lot. Okay, so the tracker is done. Once you see that it's done, we can click in the background, in the far background, select a few of these dots, right click, and create a null and camera. So now what I want to do is click on the null, press P on the keyboard, click on the position for the tracked null, and copy the position data, click on the fractal noise, toggle the switches, make sure that it's a 3D layer, and then go to position again, press P on the keyboard, click on this and paste it to get it in the exact same position. If you want, you can reposition and readjust everything, just check that it doesn't get out of frame. And actually it's doing a decent job except here, so we're gonna move this over. You can scale it, move it, and everyone is again gonna get a different result, but this is gonna get you the closest. So there we have it. And if we're gonna change this to an additive, we do get some different kind of results, I suppose. Also, I did use my 16 bits per channel, which is gonna enhance the colors of the glow a little bit. And of course, you can click on your fractal noise and go for a color correction curves and increase kind of the contrast here, maybe the colors even. And just play around with these. It's completely up to you. So here we can really get that kind of typical Northern Light. Play around with it. It's really fun. You can even apply a color correction tint effect to get it black and white, and then we can apply an effect Video Copilot VC Color Vibrance, which is a free plugin from Video Copilot, and get your colors like this. So if you want to get funky, increase vibrance, maybe put it before the glow together with the tint. It's getting some different kind of results. Maybe you want to apply a quick adjustment layer on top. With a curves and increasing the red colors a little bit to fit it together a little bit more. And yeah, just be creative. And if you want to show off your end results, you can do that with me on Instagram at Ignace Aleya. All right, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also be sure to check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for any kind of digital creative. And also be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. And apart from that, I just hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.